Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host with the most, Richard Evans. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to this video. Now today I want to talk to you about Express Mode on TriCaster. Express Mode merges your program and preview rows together as one, allowing for quick switches of your show. So it's perfect for using touchscreen interfaces. So instead of having to queue up a shot on your preview row and then do an auto transition to it to select it on your program row, all you have to do is simply click on the shot you want to use, and you have quick access to different transitions and access to two downstream keyers. So let's take a look and show you how it's done, son! All right, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and this interface is your typical interface you'd see if you were opening up a brand new TriCaster session. So you have your inputs over here in the top left, preview windows for your preview and program rows in the top right, your switcher row here in the middle, followed by your downstream keyers on the right, and then you have your media players at the bottom for like your DDRs, etc. Okay, so what I want to kind of focus on here is the program and preview rows here. So right now, if you want to do a shot, for example, if I wanted to do a transition over to my input number 6, for example, and I would just basically go through on this preview row, click 6, and then I can do a take to that, for example, and then that would swap my program and preview rows back and forth, or I can use a transition like this goofy face transition that I have here, and then you can run your show that way. Now, what's the Express Mode allows you to do is it allows you to minimize your program and preview row and basically just do one switcher row here to make things a little bit more streamlined. And to do that, you'll see right here in the bottom that I have a option for my switcher, which is my typical switcher, or I can click on Express, and when I do that, check this out. It will now kind of combine all of these into just one row. So now I can just basically go through and start to punch up different inputs so I can do transitions or takes to that, for example. Okay, but what's kind of the reason why you would have the Express Mode here, not the real reason, but a good reason, is if you had a touchscreen interface that you could plug into your system, you can go through and physically just grab your finger and just start pushing buttons and doing your show that way. So let's say for this particular show that we're going to do this hypothetical show, we don't need to be taking a look at our DDR bins as much. So we can do something as simple as just grabbing the interface here and dragging it down to the bottom of the screen, or if you want to just do it quickly, you can go to the top, click on Workspaces, and say just uncheck Show Media Tabs, and now we have a full version of our interface here. So again, if you have a touchscreen, all you have to do is either just click on the inputs themselves, or you can use this Express Mode here. So I want to focus on Express Mode here. What I want to show you, first you have your all of your different inputs available to you here, along with your buffers, etc. And then over here in the middle, this is where you have quick access to different transitions. So for example, I can say you can use either a cut or a crossfade, or I can load in some of my custom transitions that I've made or other transitions that are available to me. So for example, I'll just leave that one there. And then on the blinds, let's go ahead and just select something else. So now I can just basically switch between those transitions really quick by using this quick selection tool. All right. So let's just say I'm going to keep this on crossfade. So whenever I go to the next source, like for example, I'll switch over to my source on mix effect number 1, click on that, and then keep an eye on the program row, and you will see that it does a crossfade over to that shot. Or I can go back over here and select my twirl transition, and let's go back over to input 6, and it'll do that. Same thing, load in my custom transition here and go to back to my mix effect number 1, and then that brings in my custom transition that I built. So another way of being able to do this is you'll see that you now have quick access to your downstream keyers number 1 and 2 available, so that then I can just say slide those in really quick, again with just a touch of a button. So perfect for touchscreen interfaces, or if you just want to streamline your switcher so that you can create your show really quick. Express Mode again is perfect for touchscreen monitors and allows you to create your shows super fast. If you like this video and want a little bit more, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtekinc. And to find out more about NewTek products and services, contact your local reseller or visit our website, newtek.com, for more info. Also, be sure to tune into newtek.tv to see all the latest product updates, interviews with NewTek users and third-party developers, and a whole lot more. And if you are using NewTek products and sharing your content on social media, tag us. Tag us using the hashtags NewTek or TriCaster. We love seeing how people use our products to bring their stories to life. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on the next edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.